the graph of the normal distribution or its density function y equal to f of x is defined above is called as a normal curve, and the graph is symmetric or it is called as bell-shaped, or it is called as bell-shaped symmetric curve. By symmetric, it means that when we fold the figure along the line passing through x equal to mu, the two halves would coincide. Let us write some important properties of the normal distribution. So first important property is, or the properties of normal curve are very interesting and useful. The normal curve plays an important role in statistics. First important property is, for a normal distribution, since the curve is symmetric around mu, mean, median and mode are identical and each is mu. Therefore, mean is equal to median is equal to mode is equal to mu. The first and third quartiles are, the first and third quartiles are equidistant from the median. They are at a distance of 0.6745 into sigma each from mu. Therefore, Q1 is equal to mu minus 0.6745 sigma, and Q3 is mu1 plus 0.6745 into sigma. Now, third property is the quartile deviation. The quartile deviation QD is equal to Q3 minus Q1 upon 2, and its value is 0.6745 into sigma. Hence, quartile deviation has value equal to 2 by 3 into sigma approximately. The mean deviation is equal to square root 2 upon pi into sigma, and it is equal to 0.7979 into sigma, or it is equal to approximately 4 upon 5 into sigma. This value is approximate value. As the curve is symmetric, next is, as the curve is symmetric, measure of skewness beta 1 is equal to 0 and measure of kurtosis beta 2 is equal to 0. The first four quartiles, the first four central moments are mu1 is equal to 0, mu2 is equal to sigma square, and mu3 equal to 0, mu4 equal to 3 into sigma raised to 4. Next property is, the range is unlimited. Yes, obviously you see the graph of this normal distribution, the range of the variable x is, or you see the definition of this normal distribution density function, here the x is in between minus infinity to infinity, therefore the range is unlimited, infinite in both the directions. As the distance from the mean mu increases, the curve comes closer and closer to the x-axis but never touches it, and extends till infinity on both the sides. So if we see the curve of this normal distribution, you will observe that the range is unlimited and infinite in the both the directions. As the distance from the mean mu increases, the curve comes closer and closer to the x-axis but never touches it, and extends till infinity on both the sides. The total area under the normal curve is unity. So area under this curve is always is equal to 1. The ordinate at the mean of the distribution divides the total area under the curve into two equal parts. The area under the normal curve between mu plus or minus sigma is 68.27%. Now next important is a normal variable with mean mu equal to 0. Now let us go to this seventh property. The normal variable with mean is equal to 0 and standard deviation sigma is equal to 1 is known as a standard normal variable. It is denoted by z or the variable t. Therefore z is equal to t and it is equal to x minus mu upon sigma. We will be using z to denote the standard normal variate. Thus z is normally distributed. Z is standard normal variable with mean 0 and standard deviation 1 or variance 1. Okay. The points of inflection of normal curve are mu is equal to plus or minus sigma. For solving examples on normal distribution, we need the corresponding probabilities between the given values of x. The probability that a normal variate x lies between the two values a and b is equal to the area under the normal curve between x is equal to a and x is equal to b. So while solving the problems based on this normal distribution, we need to find identify the area between the two values of x is equal to a and x is equal to b, and that area is nothing but the area suspended by the curve, area under the curve of the function f of x or the density function f of x. Okay, in other words, probability of x greater than a less than b is equal to area under the normal curve between x is equal to a and x is equal to b. We will now learn to find the area under the curve in the next lecture. Okay, so area under the normal curve, for a normal distribution, the probability that a variable x takes values between x is equal to a and x is equal to b is equal to the area under the curve enclosed between x is equal to a and x is equal to b. Therefore, the problem of finding probability reduces to a problem of finding the area between the two given ordinates, but the different values of mu and sigma, we get different normal curves. Hence, it is difficult to calculate the values of the area of all such values of normal variate with different mu and sigma. This problem can be solved if we reduce all these normal distributions to a single normal distribution called a standard normal distribution. So as we have written here, the standard normal variable z, it is called a standard normal variable if its mean is 0 and its standard deviation sigma is equal to 1. And the standard normal variable is defined to be z is equal to x minus mu upon sigma. So z is equal to x minus mu upon sigma. It means that we are shifting the origin to mu and reducing the scale by sigma. In this case, the equation of standard normal curve reduces to y is equal to 1 upon square root 2 pi into e raised to the power minus z square by 2. Therefore, the standard normal variable has mean 0 and standard deviation 1. Standard deviation is equal to 1. and the area under the standard normal variable is taken as unity. And the area under the standard normal variable is taken as unity. Okay, so how to find these areas under the curve, we will see in the next lecture. Okay, so let us stop here and thank you for paying attention. Thank you very much.